Previously on Phoenix Wright Trials and Tribulations.
Hey Phoenix, what's the scatter say about this guy's sanity level? It says he's mad shit crazy!
And now back to staring at people!
Hello!
This is NicoB, back with some more Phoenix Wright Trials and Tribulations.
When we last left off, we completed the first part of the trial where we learned a whole lot of nothing, honestly. I don't know. We really didn't learn a whole lot from the trial. The old man came out and spit a whole bunch of gibberish, and apparently he broke the vase in there, and we learned that. This fucking definitive proof is bullshit, dude! So, yes, now we are moving on to the freaking next part of the investigation, where hopefully we'll get some fucking answers. January 7th, 12:52 p.m., Ryan Cole offices.
How do you think this trial went this morning?
How do you think it went?
It kind of been crazy there. I just wonder if that killed our chances.
Yeah, I guess it did get out of hand. Mr. Cole's testimony did nothing to help us.
I'm sure that vase thing is going to come into play somehow, but not quite sure how.
But I'm sure it'll be very important. Plus, now we don't even know the identity of the waitress who laced the coffee.
Hey, you know, I'm a little confused too, because he said that he saw someone sprinkle something in the coffee, but Maggie Bird says she saw the guy sprinkle something in the coffee, right? So,
what, did they double sprinkle it? More poison!
All we know is what old Mr. Kudo said, the apron stripes and the ribbon.
And the victim was wearing an earpiece when his eardrum was ruptured.
Talk about a terrifying case of contradictiousness.
Time to play doctor and find ourselves the cure then, huh?
We gotta find one for Maggie or she's gonna have a terminal case of guilty.
Okay, enough. Enough of the doctor metaphors. Alright, let's just go.
Let's just fucking go, Maya.
Okay.
To the detention center. January 7th, detention center. Visitor's room.
There's Maggie still in questioning.
But we got a question to ask her too. Maggie!
She fucking just bursts her hand through the window.
I'm going in there!
Keep it down, Maya. This isn't a playground, you know.
God, it's really weird. I got some new headphones because my other ones broke, and they're much more sound, I guess soundproof than the other one. So like I can't hear my voice as well when I'm talking into my microphone. So it'll take a little getting used to, but I'm just kind of like. I'm like, am I talking too loud? I can't tell.
What am I saying right now? Am I even using the right voice?
January 7th, 3 p.m.
Empty as usual.
Yeah, and it's lunchtime too.
That's it. Come on.
Yeah, that sounds like.
Oh, just call an 8, pal. Come on, I know you can't.
He's getting really worked up about something.
What else is new?
No, that's the wrong number. Damn it. Looks like an 8. Would have only netted me $5 anyway. What a ripoff! Oh, he's doing a lottery.
What's your problem, Dan Gumshoe?
It's you. I was just listening to the radio, pal.
To the radio?
And Dan Gumshoe's having lunch here!
He is, and he's having the 20 cent. Oh my god.
What can I say?
Gumshoe, what are you doing? Why are you eating this shitty food?
It's a nightmare. How am I supposed to look Maggie in the eye now, pal?
Really drove her into a corner, you know?
You always blow apart my testimony. My of all days, didn't you do it today?
Sorry, didn't you tell me to blow apart your testimony? I'm a little confused. There's weren't any holes in it, for once.
Oh. No, why didn't I blow apart it? Okay.
Yeah, what happened? Usually your testimonies are like Swiss cheese.
Swiss cheese.
What do you prefer to crumbly like aged Parmesan? Anyway, this case has already been ruled on. There shouldn't be any holes left to find.
So did Maggie say anything to you about me, I mean?
Yeah, she said she didn't want to see you again and hope to fucking die! Well, how did she put it again? I can't believe Detective Gumshoe! I hate him, so I mean it! I don't ever want to see him again! I'm going to fucking kill him! Something like that?
Oh my god, you actually told him that? Oh my god. Wow, Maya. Oh god, you're gonna fucking crush. Way to crush Gumshoe. Ah. Oh no.
Oopsie.
Way to go, Maya! Way to fucking crush Gumshoe's spirit. As if it wasn't already crushed enough.
Please take Gumshoe out of me!
Why is this happening?
He's banging his head against the wall, Nick!
Oh, God.
Stop! Oh, man. Poor Gumshoe.
Oh, God. It's the only one girl I ever loved. And the only girl I possibly had a chance of hooking up with.
It'd be funny if he turned towards us and there's just like this... He's just bleeding down the middle of his head.
It's alright, I'm fine.
I don't know if you are.
Yeah, I think I might have hit a stud. Oh, God. Why are there three of you, Phoenix? And 18 of Maya. And oh, my God. And Maggie's here, too. Oh, and Missile, the docking dog.
Hi there, it's Missile.
And, oh, God, I'm dying.
So, did you like the Twin Tees set?
I never paid that much money for lunch before. I was so nervous, my hands were shaking.
My palms are sweating, my hands are shaking, but I was still getting bitching. I was still getting boom, head job.
Still out of taste.
Well, for $20, I guess. I don't know how to describe it. Really? It was delicate. What?
Delicate? What the balls?
You mean you liked it? It didn't taste bad to you?
Well, it's gotta taste good, because I paid $20 for it.
What's the matter with him?
Looks like he's thinking.
That's it! I've been trying to think of the right word to describe the taste. I just got it right now. Bad! That's it. It tasted bad. I think I might have pounded my head against the wall a few too many times. It's kind of hard to admit it to yourself when you pay $20, though, pal.
He should have found out about the price after he'd finished eating it.
Here's why Glenn Oak came here. Have you heard about the famous Twin Tees set?
Glenn Oak, the victim, huh? Which reminds me, we still hardly know anything about the guy. Other than he's got a scouter on his face.
Why don't we ask Gumshoe when he knows Ziggis is here?
Alright.
So what are you all excited about earlier?
Huh?
That's right, you said you were listening to the radio or something.
I'm trying to get lottery numbers, right?
Oh, that was nothing. I wasn't excited. Ow!
Come on, Daddy Gumshoe, you can tell a little of me. What were you listening to?
Nothing, really. It was just, daily exercise show. Oh, come on! Really? I gotta do this with you, dude?
What the? A psyche look? Really?
Why is he trying to get so... Why does he care?
Nah, this lunch special sponsor is great.
Why are tears in your eyes?
It's like I already know what he was doing. He was just getting lottery numbers. I don't know why he's trying to hide it so badly, but...
Alright, let's ask him about him.
This guy was a real programming genius. They called him the walking computer at the place where he worked.
What happens when he crashes though? Does he just stop moving all of a sudden?
Wasn't a computer, Maya.
Oh my God, no way, dude! I want to be bionic!
Anyway, there's nothing between Maggie and the victim.
Yeah, that's what we found out yesterday, too.
And it's that Gumshoe, don't you have any information that should be more fun?
Fun? Oh, I know! So have you paid a visit to where Elg worked yet? You might as well.
His workplace, where's that?
A computer firm called Blue Screens, Inc.
Wow, I don't know if that's a very good name for a computer programming place.
Our computers get blue screens all the time! Or something like that.
Sounds like a real stable company. It's gonna be fun, Nick. Let's go!
Yours aren't really my thing, Maya.
It'll be fine. I know about the high-tech stuff.
Yeah, I wonder about that.
Yeah, it's just around the corner from this joint. You should take a look.
You ever called Blue Screens Inc., huh?
Take that!
Eat this, Gumshoe!
Oh, God, why are you throwing things at me? Now I'm sad now. You're trying to break me, dude.
The radio.
Alright, Teddy Gumshoe, tell me the truth. Who are you listening to?
No way, pal. You made a big thing out of it. I'm not gonna tell you. I'm not gonna tell you anything!
We'll see about that. We'll see about that, pal.
So your impression of me? It sucks!
Considering all the noise you were making while you were listening, it's pretty clear what kind of a radio program it was. I'd say it was related to...
Take that!
The lottery! I'm right, aren't I? You were listening to the lottery results, weren't you? You thought you'd try to win big, just like Glenn L did.
It's like you see right through me, dude!
I cracked him already?
That's why. I said it was nothing!
That was easy.
Oh, Gumshoe, you're always the easiest one.
I'm usually pretty lucky, so I figured I'd give it a try.
You're pretty lucky, I don't know about that. What's with everyone in the lottery?
Time to go.
I won 50 cents. Better to win nothing at all than half a lousy buck. I was so mad, I was like, ah!
Yeah, I know the feeling.
About the same kind of ticket as Mr. L. When they read those results out on the radio, it really gets your heart pumping. You know they broadcast it live when they're back making the numbers. It's intense, pal!
I bet that's what Glenn was listening to on the day he was killed.
Yeah, what a fucking bad way to go. That's why you don't scream out, I won the fucking lottery, dude! I just won a fucking $500,000!
Like a fucking ding-dong.
Here's my tending ticket right here! Woo!
Next thing you know, you're fucking dead.
Yeah, what time is it now?
It's game time. It's just after 1:30.
And the lottery results always broadcast at the same time.
Yeah, look, I got this flyer when I bought the ticket.
Ah, okay. But the body wasn't called until like 2:30, right? So it's this like whole hour long, this whole hour where nothing happens? Or it took that long for anyone to call it in?
Peter, that sounds so cool! I don't want to try it, Nick!
Then buy a ticket, Mayo, with your own fucking money!
It's too expensive!
It's $1!
I don't have any money!
You could steal some from fucking Gumshoe.
Okay!
Smear some of this thrilling 10 minutes of your life every Monday at 1:30 p.m.
It's so thrilling!
Yeah, so it said he died between 1:30 and 2:30. I think they said the old guy didn't call in until like 2:25. So, yeah, that's a whole bunch of time between when he died and when he was called in. Everybody in the kitchen?
Hello?
Everybody in the kitchen?
Mr. Armstrong is talking to Selwood.
Oh. Oh, hey, there's that girl.
I'll be back next month.
Oui, naturalement. Naturalement. I'll be waiting for you.
If you haven't got it by then, I'm afraid it might get a little hot around here.
Oh, what the hell? Are you like a fucking bounty hunter? Or bounty hunter? Yeah, is that right? Oh, come on. Her, a little dainty thing like her, she's coming in threatening him and saying, you know what? Don't have my money by tomorrow, cracking kneecaps or something. Oh, is she maybe related? Maybe she is. Maybe she's related to that spikier guy, right?
No, I will have everything ready, I promise.
I love fire, you know. I love the way it crackles. Ha, ha, ha.
Ew, you're creepy. Wow, I was like, oh, look at her, little dainty little thing. Oh, no, she's a fucking pyromaniac. And fucking crazy.
No, stop it, I beg of you.
Then don't let me down. I'll be watching you.
My, no, this is not necessary. You can trust me, mademoiselle.
Talk to anyone and I'll drive a knife right through your heart.
Goodness, good lord! You're scared than the other guy was.
Oh no, you do not have to worry. You know you worry far too much. Maybe this will help you relax. It is like oil of sandalwood.
I do love raw meat from time to time.
What the fuck is wrong with this person?
I'll be taking my leave. Goodbye for now. Fare thee well.
Hi, I have les shivers. I must rub some of my oil all over my naked body before I become the nervous wreck.
Don't forget the cocoa butter.
Of course, there. Oh, wee, ooh, ooh, that feels good, ooh, ooh, all over my nipples, oh, it makes my nipples so hot, ooh.
Okay, I think we better come back later. Ah!
Oh, la la, excusez-moi, monsieur.
My, no!
Ooh, would you care to help?
Oh, I'd like to help, I got it, oh, I got his belly, right, his belly button.
Ooh, Monsieur Phoenix, right, you kiss my biceps here.
No, please, I don't want to.
Your eyes. If you have trouble with your eyes, you need this. Laos and the wood.
Isn't that just leftovers of what you were just using?
Ooh, yes. Yes.
Très bien.
You don't exactly have many customers, do you, Mr. Armstrong?
None, you are right, Monzer. But perhaps that is a... This is the perfect time for you to visit me, no? Now I can give you my undivided attention and cook for you la de supreme.
Or supreme. Supreme is probably how you say. Putting on a brave face, huh?
That's what girls do, Nick!
But you are right. Business is very difficult these days. Perhaps the name is la problem. People do not think it's a stray. I just wanted people to think that my restaurant was exclusive.
So you guys said that apparently you think that... You imagine this guy having really bad French accents, but maybe it's a good thing I'm giving him this really shitty French one.
I think you're there to serve fast food on cheap plastic trays.
Nick, that's the kind of thing that can make a girl cry.
Have you gotten the Mr. Armstrong? You forgot Mr. Armstrong is a man, Maya.
No, I am a petite little tulip.
Don't tell me that.
But this restaurant is my life. It is everything to me. I will defend it to la finale. No one will take it from me.
Who was that crazy little psycho earlier? Who was that one you were just talking to?
Oh la la, you saw that?
Oh well, yes. Sorry.
So was she? She looked so polite and graceful and fucking evil!
Polite? Graceful?
She likes throwing mean fires, right?
Yeah!
I'll be back next month.
Wait, are we really? Let's flash back to 5 seconds ago. I'll be waiting for you.
If you haven't got it by then, I'm afraid I might have to get a little hot.
Okay, let's just... No, let's not do this again. I think about it. Hey, Maya, I think it's pretty clear what kind of conversation they were having.
You think so? Well, then let's show them that piece of evidence and see what happens.
What? What piece of evidence? This thing?
So long as that paper exists, I am but a delightful angel with love broken wings.
An angel, huh? Doesn't bode well with you. What do you think about it?
Oui, they kept harassing me month after month. In the end, I had to give in. I agreed to help them.
Okay. This is it. All right.
Help them with what?
My benzo, if I... May ben... Say...
Buen bien... It's not bien for them, right? It's... Ben? May buen? Buen bien? I don't know. It's like, pardon me, some of the words are, you know, they have the same word, like, bien is in Spanish, and I know that that's how you pronounce it in Spanish, but in French, is that how you say? Is it buon? Buen?
My buen?
I know, it's not like, it's not maíz, it's my, right?
My buen, sure, if I did not owe them the money, them la money, I would have refused, but my hands were tied.
Please, what did you agree to help them with?
No, and I cannot say. If I tell you that woman, she will slice me up and eat me with la Sally Garnish.
He says with a big smile and says,
ew, I wouldn't mean that he'll literally be sliced up and served with garnish. I'm going to guess that woman has something to do with your loan contract, am I right?
Aye.
Please, Mr. Armstrong, tell us about that woman. Do it.
Okay, there we go.
Who was here earlier? I take it that she's,
Why has it come to this? What a tragedy. Suddenly I find myself so deep in la debt, it is a sign of la bad world we live in, huh? Oh?
Huh?
Oh? No, I'd say it's more of a sign of la bad culinary skills.
The woman who was here, the scary woman. She's from la loan office.
Loan office? Is that where you borrowed $500,000 from?
Oui. Tender lender, it is called.
Catchy name. Just hearing it makes me want to borrow some money.
Please, you must not borrow from them. If you must know no more than $10.
$10? Sounds more like your monthly stipend, Maya.
Hey, I gotta pay more than that. Thank you very much.
You steal from me.
So what? You're not gonna do shit about it, Nick.
Damn it, she's right. So $10 the loan office you borrowed $500,000 from, huh?
I wonder if they got anything to do with this case.
Tender lender, bender.
I am a weak woman. When I am upset, I have to buy something nice to cheer me up. Thanks to him, I, loaning me la money, I have to back $500,000 now. I am like a slave. I have to do everything that they tell me.
Who's this he?
La Tiger?
Oh, I knew it! They're totally gonna either be related or just work at the same place.
The Tiger?
The Eye of the Tiger. Oui! Is La Manager the Tender Lender, a terrifying man, La Big City Monster? When he shouts at me, my knees are trembling and his voice is ringing in my ears for 3 days.
Wait, so you're telling me that you met the guy that you owed money to, but then you met him when he pretended to be Phoenix Wright, and you didn't realize it was him?
Man, these people are fucking stupid!
As soon as I hear the loud noise of that battered scooter he rides, I start to cry.
A big city monster rides a battered old scooter? Does this guy resemble me by any chance?
Oh, no. This man is a presence, a most formidable personality. Although, he does have a nice spiky hair just like you. Oui, there is a resemblance there, I suppose.
Then like a saloon office is worth checking out after all.
If you want to visit La Tenderlender, it is just beyond Vitamin Square.
Hey, Nick! If you need money, I can loan you some. As long as it's less than $3.
Fuck you, Maya.
And I stole from your wallet.
Thanks for the offer. It's beyond Vitamin Square, huh?
Do I actually have that guy in my, I don't have him in here yet. I don't have the girl in here yet either. Okay.
All right, to Tenderlender Bender Sender.
Well, I'm gonna head back to the precinct now. We got a big meeting starting in a bit.
About Maggie's case, you mean?
No, that's pretty much wrapped up now. There's no big case going out at the moment, so she's been pushed aside.
Okay, well, see you later then.
Bye. I fade away. I'm back again.
There you go, Detective. You'll be late.
Actually, I got a favor to ask. The big one, please.
A favor?
Yeah, it's for Maggie. Actually, I was kind of hoping you give this to her for me.
Oh no, what did he make her a little lunch or something?
What is it?
It's a lunchbox. I got it early so I can make it.
Gumshoe, you're so funny, Gumshoe. He's kind of a ding dong, but it's like he's a lovable ding dong.
I've been real worried about her. She looked like she lost a bit of weight.
Dead Gumshoe. How many Wheaties are in here? Is that person who needs to go down this much meat?
You think? I love Wheaties. I can't get enough of their tender juiciness. So we have turns and we age to make, so please will you pal? It took me 3 hours to make this many Wheaties. Yeah, gladly.
Yeah, I think no, can I? All right, fine.
Maybe I'll eat myself if I get hungry.
Don't forget, okay? Okay, I'm gonna give that to Maggie. No, you eat it, Maya, I swear to God. This is my end with her.
He's finally gone.
Look how he faded back in. That still made me laugh. Oh, fuck me, his scooter's here.
Son of a bitch.
Wait, was it still here from last? I can't remember. It got wrecked, right? So I guess it's just been sitting here.
I see Savage good to you.
They're going to buy another ton of bird seeds. It's kind of hoping you wouldn't be here anyway. At least not for now. Besides, any more seeds today and I'm liable to turn into a real phoenix.
That fucking scooter.
Hey, check this out.
I wouldn't get too close to that if I were you. Otherwise, you might be in for a shock. My money must be lurking someplace nearby. Just imagine, a tiger loose in the city. And I'm a dragon.
I don't know, I'm pretty sure a dragon could fuck up a tiger, honestly.
Meanwhile, the real phoenix is like an abandoned chick lost in a vast urban jungle.
Huh?
Don't worry, someday you'll grow up and become a ferocious tiger too. Don't lose hope.
Why are you trying to pep talk me into becoming my phony? Stop reading my mind, Maya.
I'm inside your brain. Booga, booga, booga.
Oh my God. They got a fucking punching bag in here. What in the hell is that behind them? You see the thing right below the sign? The sign says what? Win through compromise or something? And then what is that? Like she got like a little face on it. And then there's a little purple boombox or pink boombox. This guy really likes pink color.
January 7th, Tenderlander.
This place gives off a really strange vibe, doesn't it?
Looks like the tiger isn't in his lair. And that is, as they say, a very good thing.
Oh. Welcome.
Oh, go. Talk about a creepy voice that makes your soul want to shrivel up and die.
Welcome. You're here to discuss alone?
No, not exactly. You've got a big band-aid on your head, I think.
Or is that a hat?
The manager is away at the moment. Wait quietly, please. Please.
She's gone! Just like that! She actually evaporated into the air!
Here's what's come back another time.
There's a perfect opportunity, Dick! This place makes us suspicious. Come on, Dick! Let's take a look around, okay?
Do you think it'd be okay?
Of course! No one will ever know!
Coffee, except for me, because I'm here. I am everywhere.
Ah!
I'll leave it here for you to enjoy. Quietly.
Yes! Yes, thank you!
Do not touch the desk, please. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Nick! Let's get out of here!
No, she wants to get out of here. Too bad we're looking around. I'm touching that desk. I'm gonna slap my fucking dick on it. Arrgh! There's a CD player on the desk. But the desk is so loud, I wonder if you can hear it.
The lid's open. What kind of music Tiger's into?
Oh, I bet it's got the fucking disc that was from the cafe, or from Tribiana, right?
Have you finished the coffee?
Good lord! Where are you coming from? Yes, thanks. It was lovely.
So, you drank it all?
Gulp!
You're going to die now. If you touch anything else that doesn't belong to you, there's always another cup. Always. Always.
The cup, it was like, I'm almost sure of it.
Nick, my stomach! It's killing me! Oh, God! Oh, God, this is the end, Nick! Oh, Jesus! I'm vomiting up all those Wheaties I ate from Gumshoe's lunch!
Oh,
blah,
blah. Oh, God! Oh, God! Blah, blah, blah. Oh, why? No, I knew I would die this way. Fucking hell, Maya! It's all your fucking
fault! What is that my fault? You touched the stupid pooper!
Oh dear, they appear to have died. I guess it must have been that new creamer I used. I didn't even lace the coffee with anything, what the fuck? Oh wait, maybe it was just the burger I ate for breakfast?
I sure hope so. We better take a look at the CD while we're alive and have the chance. What the?
What? It's not the Rocco soundtrack, is it? Pull out the chart! Oh my god!
Wow, they're really...
Man, what a cleverly done reference that was. I wonder who they could possibly be referring to. Rocco.
It's not the Rocco's Modern Life soundtrack, is it?
Claw of the Tiger.
It's the Claw of the Tiger.
It's a demo CD. Your name has been handwritten on the disc in pen. MC Bomber. I fucking knew it.
Wobbly!
This must be a CD Maggie told us about.
Let's listen to it. I bet it's heavy metal.
No way that woman will make us drink more coffee than we do. And then we'll die we'll die for real this time.
What in the fuck is that?
You see, it's round dome thing he's calling Daruma, I think.
Oh, that's a funny looking Daruma though, isn't it?
Figured I'd read a book or two and be more cultured in case you're wondering.
You mean you're making stuff up for a change?
I mean, you also didn't know that no matter what, he'll always write himself. Go ahead, Nick. Give him a good shove.
Only if I feel like dying.
Yeah, this yellow thing, this is a piece of... It's a Japanese chess piece. I think it's a king. Not that I'm an expert or anything. I'm more of a reversing person, you know.
Assuming she knows what she's talking about, these aren't exactly your typical mobster wannabe items. They're not trophies, are they?
Hey, there's a piece of paper sticking out from under here.
Oh, sweet. What is it? Repair bill? Oh my god, I don't believe I found something. Looking at the Daruma doll. Looks like he did some repair work on this car. Did he even have one? $15,000 to replace a bumper and a light? That's fucking bananas!
Cars racer 2, the Cataverinus?
Oh, so it's not even the Tiger's car? Why does someone else's repair bill be in the tiger's office?
Maybe it's disguised as a repair bill, but it's actually the money someone owes or something. What in the hell does that say? We went through some compromise? Oh, it is, yeah, went through compromise.
I wonder what that's supposed to mean.
It must mean something that if they took the trouble to frame it like that.
Yeah, well, it just doesn't make any sense to me.
Ah!
That.
Blah, blah!
That's Tenderlender's guiding principle. Oh! Compromise the customer to win.
Oh, I see. How about you, Nick?
Compromise the customer.
Yeah, well, as long as we don't have to compromise my hair, I'd say we're okay. That's what slogan no business owner should ever explain to their customers.
Ugh. Oh, it's like, this is a fucking creepy she looks.
And she fades into nothing again. Ooh, check out the sweet coat.
Hey, look at this Parisian style coat. It's so chic.
By the way, you guys told me. I kind of realized it afterwards. I was like, oh, that's not chic. It's chic. I always thought chic was spelled it. I was like, that was a French word, isn't it? I never realized that. Like, I've heard the word, like, said before, chic, but I've never, spelled out. I thought it was spelled as S-H-E-E-K. Actually, is that a word, too? I don't know.
Looks more like a pip coat to me, because I haven't got an eye profession.
Hey, look at this! The suit is the same color as the one you wear, Nick!
Oh, yeah. Huh. Same color as my suit.
Ah!
Your voice, am I?
Nick, you gotta take a look at this!
Some cake.
Ah! Stop giving us things to eat and drink!
I'll just leave it here for you.
Oh, yeah, sure! I am, thanks!
Just wait here quietly, otherwise...
Sure! Did you hear that, Nick? Wait quietly, you little puffy face!
Yeah, sure! We're being so quiet right now! Arr!
I have my eye on you, only so I can take care of you. Understand? Do you? Do you?
Yes.
I'm scared, Nick. I pee myself.
No, oh, what were you getting so excited about before?
I'm gonna lap up the pile of soup.
That's... Oh! It's an attorney's badge! A fake shitty one! Made of cardboard. It looks nothing like the real thing. Nothing like my actual grown-up badge.
Is the tiger a lawyer?
No way! Look at this badge, it's made of paper.
Paper badge.
For some reason, your badge sort of looks really cheap to me, Nick.
Why does anyone recognize an obviously fake badge when they see one? Come on! Don't I show it to you guys enough? Well, obviously has to start showing it even more often.
Oh no, someone dropped an asteroid on the floor! It's gonna be a nightmare to clean up.
Yeah, it's all over the rug and everything.
Actually, knocked over a really big space heater once. They help us in the pain. It's one of those super antiques we have to burn a ton of charcoal.
How did you manage to knock one of those over? Are they supposed to be like super heavy?
I'm He-Man! Oh hey, there's a book of matches here! Oh
my god, I'm fighting so many things here! I'm just fucking looking around. I can't believe like everything I've examined so far has had something in it.
Badges, huh? Ladies don't give those that much day nowadays. Hey, wait a second.
What is it?
Look what's printed on the back. It says Travian.
Oh my god.
Badges could come in handy. We might be able to use them to burn something.
Yeah, pilot light for the office boiler keeps going out.
Swing and a miss, Maya. Swing and a miss.
Oh god. Well, looks like our friend arrived.
Come out from the under the desk, Maya. What are you two snooping around my office for, huh? You think you can come here and just do what you want? My precious copper, you two's got ash in my rug. You're gonna wish you were that. Yo, the fee never came through my door. It wasn't us, it was already late. You just wanna argue with me. Is that what you're doing? You think you just take me up? I got motherfucking family flattening you two into pancakes and jungles in my news rug. I've got fucking demon fangs.
Oh.
Oh. Don Tiger, you're back, Tigre.
Ah, that voice, it's evil seeping into the head through your ears.
Ooh, hello. I'm sorry. Don Tigre? Don Tigre. I knocked over that ash tree before, and...
Ah! She had a death wish or what?
Ah! Oh! Oh my god, he's afraid of her too, isn't he?
Oh, right. Huh? Forget about it, but feel that. It's not... What? I ain't gotta get mad at you. You're too gooey here. That's so unfair!
Here, have some cookies. I just baked them. And you'll need some strong espresso while you're discussing your loan. Goodbye!
Is he afraid of her, or is he just have the hots for her?
Phoenix Wright. Yes? You're either crazy or just plain stupid and chase after me. I worked so hard, but now you just gotta come and mess up my plan. So it was him. He's my phony. Ha! But I don't care. No one gets in my way. What? I mean, excuse me? Ha ha! Ha! You should've let that little girl home, right? I have a few other things I wanna go- No, Quest, this is the last time we meet. Ah, wait! Please!
That was pretty weak, Nick. Wait till he was out of here before you shout after him!
Like you're one to talk, I didn't hear you scream, hold it! Hold either. I go, hold it!
The espresso.
Stop giving us things!
And cookies.
This woman is definitely not good for my heart. Now, what was it the tiger called her? Violetta?
Hello there. Welcome to Tenderlander.
So, kinda curious about your company, Tenderlander.
With the warm and friendly atmosphere you'd expect from a family-sized business, a conscientious rate of interest, and an attractive payment repayment policy.
Well, I don't get the feeling this sentence is not going to end well.
We will tenderly lend you that little bit extra here at Tenderlender.
Hey, Nick! Things are a bit tight for Wright and Go at the moment, aren't they? I mean, there's that $500 you owe me from our car game for starters! Why don't you get a loan?
Fuck that! Would I like to get a loan from a place like this? Not so much.
Oh, I thought it was actually going to give me the option to do it. I was like, am I fucking insane?
Tenderlender is on your side.
Hey, you stole Nationwide slogan!
Not anymore, it isn't. You see, the Nationwide CEO had come down with a bit of a heat stroke.
Uh-oh. So, let's say I'm late with my repayment. What happens then?
We give you more coffee. Strong coffee.
Right. So something tells me that, Glenn Elg must have had something with, had a debt he owed to them, right? And I guess they poisoned him with some fucking strong coffee. So, I'm wondering, was it her then, or was it the other guy? Maybe it was her that actually killed him, and then the tiger was the one who just pretended to be Phoenix or something?
I'm right, I think I'd rather skip town.
You just remember, I can make strong coffee too, Nick! Strong tea as well! I could kill you if I wanted to.
Thanks, Maya. So, you know about the incident we're investigating?
What incident?
Well, man was poisoned in a restaurant near here. That incident.
Let me see. I was here that day with the manager.
The manager being the tiger.
Furio Tigre.
Furio?
Tigre? So that's where the tiger comes from.
Zenioff's got a real name, Nick. Hurry up and find out more about him.
Zenioff. Okay. God, finally you've been fucking at it. Ask you about the tiger. I mean, Mr. Tigre.
Cookie?
Cookie?
Sure. How do you like my cookies? I bake them myself.
Go ahead, Nick. Yours, all yours.
No, ladies first, Maya. You're my guinea pig. I can't die. The game's named after me. So you gotta go first. Whenever I look at this, I just don't get it. What are the tiger and the scary girl doing working together?
We are lovers.
That's not exactly coming across in your tone of voice.
Are you serious?
We are lovers.
Lovers.
And didn't I say that to myself in my head? How does she know? How does she answer my question like that?
And I owe Don Tigre my life. He's the one who saved me.
A tiger saved you?
Please, address him properly as Don Tigre. Otherwise, I'll have to.
Okay, Don Tigre, fine, of course. Sorry. Saved your life? Would you like to know how that happened?
Partially part of the tender staff at Tenderlander, a thoroughly bitter person. The head of the Tenderlander Loan Company, also known as the Tiger. Alright. I just present the stir.
I'm about this.
More coffee. You must have more.
You must have more. No, thanks. I've had enough, really.
Really? Usually when you present their own picture to them, they say something.
I don't leave the office. I can't tell you anything except Don Tigre.
Don Tigre. Don Tigre, May.
I'm very frail, you see. Just recently, I died once.
You died? What?
About 4 months ago, the doctor said to abandon all hope.
I guess they're taking her to take a boat ride across the river Styx.
But Don Tigre, he saved me. He gave up everything.
Everything?
When I found out what he had done for me, I was happy.
No offense, but I find it hard to believe.
Can't you see how happy I am right now? I decided to pay him back with my life by serving him coffee and espresso.
I still wonder about what's in her coffee. So, is that what you've got that bandage around your head?
This.
Yeah, I'm wondering about that.
So what's the story with the bandage?
They put it on after the operation.
Operation?
It's just a little injury. A little fatal injury.
A fatal injury?!
I had a severed one herself by the sound of it. Though, that's the injury you were talking about before when you said you died once.
Oh, are you serious? Oh my god. Four of them? Jesus! Are you serious? I'm gonna try to break her psyche locks. That sounds like it'll end in death.
You really creeps me out, Nick.
Same here, but we gotta find out what the truth. But we'll do it later. Run.
Memory 7, vitamin square.
There he is! I'll see you back for your page again.
Hey there, take this and this! Get out of my park! Eat and die, pigeons, eat and die!
Like I thought
he's really mad. Come on, Maya, just keep your head down and let's sneak away while we still can.
Well, what? Hello, man!
No, Maya! What are you doing, Maya? Huh? Yes, you little shits.
He's turning back on us.
I'm not surprised. I bet I really heard his pride in the court this morning.
Hey, Miss Gudo. Granny, talk to you, alright?
Out with the demons! Out with the good fortune!
Ow, shit, show splinters, painful.
I always knew you were a demon, Maya. You fucking demon lord. Hey, no hard feelings, right? Oh, I'm sorry about what happened in court earlier today. Everyone be talking about me behind my back now. A dirty old man who was so busy looking at the serving girl's backside that he can't remember her face, a filthy depraved animal. Not at all. Not like anybody knew who you were anyway. Hey, listen to me, boy. I don't care what you say. I saw that waitress put it in. She puts a white pattern in the young lad's cappuccino.
It's totally gonna be in the girl with the bandage. I mean, the hair. She has the same kind of short, dark hair that Maggie has. Although I guess you must take the bandaid off.
We hear you.
Nothing. The young lady about was wearing an earpiece. On the same side as the lens of his broken spectacles.
Really sorry.
So I made a little mistake about the vase. So what?
Yeah, this guy actually might end up being right about this, you know? But why would the guy have an earpiece in his deaf ear, you know? The ear that he's trying to recover from.
I know what I saw, I tell you!
I feel kind of bad for this guy, honestly.
Okay, take it easy, Mr. Grado, please. Don't tell me take it easy, Spike here, Brett, take this! Please!
You say you're a craftsman, right?
I'm real capsule, I'm scratching like me, sounding gross.
Surely he's not dead!
I come from a long line of craftsmen, right back to the time of Shogun's. You hear me? I didn't become an embroiderer, I was born one!
Actually, I'm kind of in the same situation myself.
I wanted to stick my fingers up that dribbling old judge's nose. I thought he was going to say something else there. Up his... and straight right down his ear hole. Objection!
What? Are you challenging me? I am the Lord of all time! I am older than all of you!
I am older than you!
No, I'm older and more senile!
Stop it, you two sexy beasts. God, fighting over me like this.
Who the fuck are you?
Oh, yeah, it's my lover, Kameda. We have lots of unprotected bagel sex.
Wait, what? What the balls?
Oh, so when did you want to become a lawyer when you were young?
I don't think that's quite it, Maya. I think he's just in a bad mood, that's all.
I've got tsunami frustration inside and it's really ready to burst.
If we let him start rambling now, I might never shut up.
What should I do?
Suck it up.
I think I better let him talk. There's not much to call for the craftsmen in these days, then.
Of course not, you idiot! All I'm good for nowadays is running errands.
Errands?
Everyone takes advantage of the elderly. Buy some bread, cramps. Take the dog for a walk, granddad. Feed the pigeons, old man. What am I, some sort of two-bit community handyman?
Oh, well.
Buy some bread. Now that I can understand. What's the point of feeding some city pigeons?
Well, really, that... So you were out here doing this because somebody asked you to do it?
Well, people say what they mean. Get lost. That's what you're trying to say. Burn! I love seeds, they're so delicious. Oh yes, I'm just an inconvenience, you see. At home, at the restaurant, I just get in the way, don't I? I'm sure you don't.
Wait a minute, what did you just say? At home, at the restaurant?
Hold up, my restaurant, are you talking about Trabien?
Did you get asked to run an errand there too?
Yeah, yes I did, the very day that young Brett was poisoned.
Oh my god.
What the fuck, old man? What? What is it?
So the day of the incident, what were you asked to do? Glad yes, boy! I'll tell you what I was asked to do. All of a sudden that young lad slumped over the table. Sherman girl collapsed. And I broke the vase. It all happened so fast I was in a bit of a daze, see? And the owner shouted over to me, it's like in that crazy language of his.
Excuse me, you called the police.
Calm yourself. I should have sat back, but I didn't think of it at the time.
So, did you end up calling the police?
Like I said, I was in a bit of a daze.
Did you call them on your cell phone?
I look like I got one of those newfangled thingamajiggers. Thingamajiggers behind the name. We're not looking for a payphone, of course.
You were looking for one?
I couldn't find one right away, you know. Went around for like 5 minutes or so.
5 minutes?
Or 5 minutes after the incident happened. Yes, sirree! The owner was at Trabien on his own. Why didn't you mention this in court this morning? Well, I would have had if you give me the chance. But you booted me out of the courtroom, you son of a doodle!
Oh, thank you, Mr. Kudo. You certainly earned your kudos for today. See what I did there? Suck my dick, old man.
Wait a minute, that's Kids Moore, I gotta say. Oh, yes, I remember something else.
Bail him!
Yes, Edgy.
Squirrel Woods out of the courtroom. Get him out of here. There's only one old man that's allowed to be in this game, and that's me.
It's not my fault. You're the ones to blame.
Could have at least told us before we got to court.
Really, that poor Mr. Kudo was the one who called police?
I mean, I think we already knew that, though.
Yeah, what's important is the unaccounted kind of time before the police arrived.
Yeah.
The victim was dead. And Maggie was unconscious. Which leaves that woman, I mean the man, alone in the restaurant. Mr. Kudo might have been chased out of the place on purpose.
What do you mean?
Ooh, so he did have something to do with it. Oh, I bet he's totally under the thumb of the tiger and the girl, right? So I bet he must know about what happened here. So he's probably working with them to cover this up, you know, by saying that there was no one else at the booth with him, even though he knows there was, because he knows that the guy is the person that has him under his thumb, right?
What do you mean?
Yeah, sir, someone didn't want him in the restaurant.
Ah!
Oh, sure, sure you go ahead and say I was in the way as usual. That's why I should have been getting myself covered in pigeon poop instead of him. What do you get more details about what exactly happened? From Maggie and from Mr. Armstrong. Thanks, old man. Yeah, shut up. Help you fucking die. Help you fucking fall down and die. Help you pay for death.
You know anything about this guy?
Would you mind taking a look at this? You let me get a million of my grumbles off of my chest, and now take one quick look. I got this great fresh rainbow in the bumble. Forget it. Man grumbles for one look at it.